Oh man. Good morning. Wakey wakey. Happy Wednesday. Happy Danish Pipes Wednesday. Hope you slept incredible. Man, I slept alright. Tossed and turned a couple of times, just trying to get comfortable. But I slept pretty good. I was up at 4 and I was like, damn. Okay, I'm just gonna roll over for like 10 minutes. And 10 minutes was 60 minutes. But I needed it. Yeah, I'm not too hard on myself if I get an extra hour of sleep. Because I could use it. I'm trying to make up for 20 years of lack of sleep. I starved myself from healing powers for 20 years, so not anymore. Oh, feeling that fucking training yesterday, I'll tell you that. Okay, I'm gonna get off here and get moving. See how Wednesday morning is going. Go outside, see what it looks like. It might be wet. It was fucking raining last night. Let's go see.
Good morning. You wakey wakey?
Yeah, a little wet out. Ooh, you can feel it in the air too. This is the type of morning where if you ride to the skate park, your board is soaked. Gotta bag it before you leave, so. I think we're gonna save the skate park today.
Do some walking. Yeah? You go do some walking? Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, ready for a girl? Oh, good morning. Rise and shine. Hope you can make it outside today. Getting those steps in. Oh. Oh, it's a beautiful steamer outside. Cheers to the healers. Man, I need some relief, some pep in my step already. Feeling it today. Definitely, my Wednesday feels like my last Friday. It's all right. We're outside, we're moving. Taking it slow, taking it easy. We're gonna head to the gazebo, get a nice stretch, then head back. And that should be good. Oh man, I'm so sore today. Fuck. All right, let's get walking. Get me up that hill. This is how you program your sleep. And if you don't think it works, well, I'd fucked up sleep for 20 plus years and I programmed it myself. by doing this and that. All right, diary, here's how I'm feeling. Got a little bit of that relief stick early this morning. Put some pep right back in my step. Got my muscles loosened up and relaxed. So the tension is off, making the walk a lot easier. Whew. Still got a sore back, but it's more my lower back muscles that have been like dealing with my back. But it slowly feels like it's getting better. Okay, back in the pocket. Okay, we're walking that way. That's where the gazebo is. So we gotta go all the way around town to get there, which we enjoy. Especially all the shade. This is the shadiest route in the Golden Triangle. Whew. Go find your shade. Get outside.
There's the gazebo.
I got a funny story to tell you when we get closer.
There says gators.
Okay, so word on the street is apparently on Sunday Fun Day, the entire boardwalk was closed. My mom said that they came out here early in the morning, there was a 10-foot gator eating a vulture on the dock. And they couldn't get him to go, and they had to shut the whole place down and wait for him to get back in the water and then decide if they were going to remove him because he was a threat. And it's like, he's only a threat because all these stupid fucks come here and they feed the gators. And there's signs everywhere that say, don't feed the gators, because then the gators will take over your walkway. Yeah.
Morning.
Hi, good morning.
How y'all doing?
Good. Hello. Yeah, it says. When you don't respect nature, nature takes over your walk path. Woo, you want to talk about humidity? Steaming in the swamp right now. So there's monster gators that hang around this corner right here. The female lays her eggs over there. So a lot of people don't think, because this is a trail, that they're gonna see gators anywhere in here. And guess what? I've been walking in here and seeing the motherfucker sitting right there waiting on somebody. Look at him. Here's where Mr. Frog was getting eaten the other day. Poor guy. I don't want to see any of that shit today. Let's see, we came from way over there. I made it to the gazebo. Let's get this stretch on. Good in here.
Don't step in shit that you can't handle. Walking in the dark, man, so you need a candle. Can your ass pay? I want you with money. Wanna sell weed, but you stay getting money. Cross head cutters from the hood, now you want it. Just like a man to the dirt, you love money. When they catch you, you prepare.
Good stretch. Oh, man. Definitely feel a lot better now. It was a pretty tight, constricted walk all the way here. And, you know, a nice stretch before that is just all the movement and all the uphill, downhill puts my body in different kind of state. I gotta come here and fucking stretch it back out and get it balanced so I feel balanced again. Okay, we're on the move again. Definitely feeling better. That stretch is everything, man. Can't start the day without it. Oh, we're on a water break. Yeah. All right, made it to our favorite porch. Got a bathroom break. Whew. Cooling off, getting some water. It's a fucking steamy one. Yeah. We're almost to the truck. Okay, we're on the move. Cool down. Taking it slow. I escape this. Let's see. Gotta come in right there and then launch all the way over that crack. Totally doable. One day. We made it, pretty girl. Feels good in here. Let's get home. God, it's fucking heat. Good morning.
Good morning.
Go get him. Oh, there's a new toy.
Well, good morning. Oh. Good morning, little girl. What you got there? What is that?
Yeah, I want the guts now. Give me those guts, man. Give me those guts.
Where's he going? Cheers. 100 degrees out right now. 11:15. It's fucking... Alright, gonna finish this. Then we're gonna soak my body in the bath. I'm feeling it, my ass muscles, my legs, my quads, calves, my shoulders, my arms, just everything. I'm feeling it today, so I'm just trying to get ahead of it. Go soak in Epsom salt. See how I feel when I get out of the bath.
And... we discuss science and science-based. Oh. I'm Andrew Huberman, and I'm a professor of neurobiology and ophthalmology at Stanford School of Medicine. Today, we are going to discuss your brain chemistry and how to control and optimize your brain chemistry for all aspects of mental health, physical health, and performance. Many times before on the Huberman Lab podcast, and frankly, every time I'm a guest on another podcast, I get questions about science and science-based tools for things like enhancing sleep, enhancing focus, enhancing creativity, improving relationships, getting over grief, and on, all of which are valid questions and for which there are protocols that are based in science and that work the first time and every time. However, far more important than knowing a protocol is understanding why a given protocol works. That's why I'm always hammering on mechanism and explaining the cells and circuits and chemicals, at least to some detail, so that people can understand not just what to do, but why it works and therefore how to change a protocol as their life circumstances change or as goals change. Now today we are going to go even a layer deeper. We're going to explore the foundations of your biology in your brain and body that allow any protocol to work, because as it turns out, all of the protocols out there, whether or not it's a breathing protocol or a supplement or a prescription drug or an exercise routine, they all tap into and leverage a core set of just a few biological mechanisms. That's right. Beneath everything you are able to do and feel, and indeed beneath every protocol that allows you to change for the better and optimize your mental health, physical health, and performance, there's just a small subset of chemicals that you're leveraging toward that change. So today we're going to talk about the four major pillars of neurochemistry that allow you to, for instance, be focused when you want to focus, that allow you to relax when you need to relax and de-stress, that allow you to optimize your sleep, that allow you to optimize your exercise routine, or to work through a pain point in relationship or in career or in your relationship to yourself. So what I can say for sure is that by the end of this episode, you will have a much richer understanding about how your brain and nervous system, and indeed your entire body, work, and you will have a much firmer understanding as to which protocols and tools to reach for, given your particular goals in the moment, in the day, across the week, across the month, across the year, and indeed across your entire lifespan. Let's talk about how to optimize and indeed how to control your brain chemistry for sake of health and performance. Now, in order to do that, we all need to be on the same page about some basic facts. Some of those basic facts involve learning some basic biology. And I promise that even if you don't have a biology or chemistry background, everything I'm about to say should be accessible and clear to you. The important thing to know is that your brain and your spinal cord and the rest of your so-called nervous system control all the organs of your body, and that all the organs of your body feed back, meaning they communicate through chemicals and other means to your nervous system. Now, your nervous system plays a particularly important role in generating everything from sleep to wakefulness, creativity, stress, calm, etc., by way of a particular type of cell-cell interaction, and that's called synaptic communication.
In that time.
That was a good nap.
Ooh, dinner time. Lean ground beef and an egg. Jalapenos, onions. Yummy fucking.
They're telling me we're going to try to break it too. Ricky.
All right, I'm going to make some refreshing dessert. Half packet of lime, half of a packet of orange. Ooh, yeah. Okay, about a half a packet. How refreshing that is. It's 107 degrees out right now, let me tell you. Had a bath, got a 2-hour nap, feeling a little bit more rested and solid than I felt earlier. Man, I was just feeling it. Lean ground beef burger for dinner with one egg, some kimchi. Just keeping it light. And then this is my dessert. Water, ice, coconut milk, and half a packet of orange limit and half a packet of citrus. And it tastes like a frozen margarita. Virgin. So fucking good. Yeah, I got my own slushy. It's my own snow cone. Mmm. Definitely feel better after the bath and the nap, though. It's like I just needed more sleep, more rest, more recovery time. I'm going back in. It's too fucking hot out here.
Alright, so this one's waxed. That one's dry. This one's crazy dry.
Ooh. Okay. Got a re-drill. And grip. Alright, about to get a big old storm coming in here soon. Cheers to the healers. Finally, it's cooling off. God damn. Last time I came out here was 107. Now it's about 90. With a warm breeze. Hopefully once it rains, a cool breeze will come in. All right, yeah, so yesterday I did some part swapping on some skateboards, and here in a little bit, after I get a little relief, I'm going to go build a new board. Got used trucks, used wheels, used bearings, just new deck, so, but we gotta re-drill it, so that's next. After the storm.
And that's what I was just telling my dad about.
As soon as I walked out and I told you about that lightning, another fucking bolt of lightning came, so I could see it even better.
Alright, I feel lightning's gonna strike. Big old fucking pulsating bolt right about there. Damn. Surge in the energy. It's pissed off out there. All right, let's see. I got arts and crafts going. I got parts galore ready. I got some customization going. And let's get the re-drilling.
There's a lot of people on the list, and Tony reeled you on first.
Yeah, what was that?
You saw, yeah, but you...
I was shy. What, were you drinking? I was trapping. I hunted a celebrity, and I saw an
arcade. I didn't really about that.
Okay, so, well, here we go. I have seen many times on comments on our podcast, people requesting you be on.
Wow.
That
friends were lit and kind of like... had $700 sneakers, and they were bitches, man. I didn't say it, but they were bitches.
Right,
and
right.
Now, he hangs out with a bunch of dudes that skate, surf, and jump BMXs all day,
mm-hmm.
and shoot firecrackers out of their ass. And I'm like, that's a man.
That's a better life.
It is. I do feel way, when I send me videos of his friends having firecrackers shoot out of their ass, I'm like, you'll be all right.
Yeah, well, you see all these kids now with the social media, and now I sound like a 90-year-old man. These kids today, but they're all like, their anxiety's through the roof, suicide is up, and depression is up, and it's like, if you just went outside and fell down and tried to skate and learned how to heel flip, I feel like you'd be a happier kid.
Yep, you're right.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely what we're advocating for with doing skate parks, too.
Oh, yeah.
My childhood was. Yeah. My 20s, you know, I never thought of my 20s.
I saw a thing today say people wouldn't take a job for a lifeguard, Tim Dillon's job. Lifeguards are hard to come by because people don't want the job because they don't get to swipe. They have to work, they have to wash, they have to wash. They have to wash. People don't drown, and people find that to be an unbearable job. And I'm like, you're in a seat on the beach.
The only requirement really is beyond knowing CPR is that you have to pay attention.
Exactly. That's it. But that's a
good money too, he said.
It's sad because lifeguard was like speak of the devil. You check this phone.
He's got
Jeremy's safe theater camp.
But that's the rub now, is like everything, we get so technologically advanced and modernized and like normal stuff is now flavor. You know, yeah. Like you gotta just sit there on the phone, I can't do that for granted. Psycho, but that was just normal, you know?
It's like someone telling me I'm just gonna sit here and not drink a bottle of whiskey. It's like, yeah. A lot of people do that. Not that hard.
We talked about that recently where you, or even with your parents,
you're going to the bank, you're going to the bank, going to the bank, standing in line,
getting your own scratches.
It was a
work on your nothing and get fine.
Yes. Yes. And there you go. And then you try to go inside, your mom's like, get back out there.
Yeah, alright, I guess it's back outside. Yeah, it's a little different now.
Yeah, yeah. I can't tell if it's better or worse, like, oh, damn, like, cigarettes. You know, like, you used Twitter when you were pregnant? Holy shit. You know? It's a great joke. I wonder if we're getting there. Like, we're starting to see the side effects of the bad symptoms of social media or whatever. Who knows?
I feel like being stationary for long periods of time is not healthy for humans. And I feel like phones...
Oh, really? How long are you shitting now? I used to shit 8 seconds, now I'm like, well, let me read more in peace.
One of my kids, we just talked about that, like, how are you in there for 40 minutes? Well, I finished early, but I just, you know, sit there.
Just scrolling.
And what?
YouTube.
Yeah, whatever.
It's right there.
It's bad for you. Buttholes.
But yeah, but I mean, it, every time, it's like 30 to 40 minutes. I'm an everyman.
Yeah.
I'm skating it.
Hey, okay.
Rolex is free to fix. It's a lifetime warranty. You can just go in and go, hey, the pan broke, and they'll fix it. Fun fact.
I'm going to tell my business manager that.
Yeah, there you go.
What the damn?
Uh-huh. I do love that car. I bought a scooter.
It still runs?
Oh, it runs like a champ. And really, I have a friend, he's a mechanic. He did all the work. I mean, look at Daewon Song. I mean, all the guy needs is a curve. But this guy can do,
That's not normal.
No, that's not. I mean, he's an anomaly.
These trucks... are so
frustrating. Caps that make the shells fall, ski mask over my skull. Nipples in my mouth, cause I'm real. Bitch, it's a house called Clock 9 with no love. Killers from the south got a pill. Caps that make the shells fall. Yeah, it's woke in the belly of a nipple.
As soon as I came to America and watched these people do it real life in front of me, I went back to Australia as easily the best skateboarder in Australia.
Whoa.
And I'm like, how'd you learn that many tricks? I'm like, because I saw everybody do it right in front of me every day.
Yeah. We even though it's possible, it's a little easier to
exactly.
From the hood, now you want it. Just like a man to the dirt, you the honey. When they catch you, you prepare for the slaughter. Don't look surprised, you can step in that quota. Kick in your nose, put the gun to your daughter. Business and shit like seal.
Alright, so I've got Indy 149s on a 9-inch board, so normally you would put Indy 159s, so I'm going to show you how to make 149s and a 159s. They're damn near the same. Two washers that come stock with the truck, and a third one. Do it all the way around. I'll show you.
Some weeks are good and they fly by and everything's great, and some weeks are tough, you know, because all the guests we have, you know, we don't just come in and film on Wednesdays. We got, you know, guests coming in.
Okay, so here's a set of 159s, and I've got these spaced out.
and they're just about the same. So,
it's a trick tip. If you need wider trucks for your board, space them out. It's lighter too. Still raining out, so I doubt we'll be skating in the morning. Looks like we're walking in the morning. Maybe sleeping in too.
Get him a little air tag.
They do have those, and they have them in. Oh man, this is gonna be fun. What? Gonna be fun.